Okay, mic is on. Everything's on. Alexa, turn the studio lighting on. Alexa, turn the studio lighting on.
Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have.
What is up, everybody? Bobby here, the Nintendo Guru. Time for the breakdown. And here's how it works. Every single week, Monday through Friday, I take the top Nintendo stories of the day, talk about them, discuss them, break them down, give my opinions on them. So,
here we go.
So I want to do something a little different this particular day, and I want to try to do this every single month if I can, if I remember. So today is the 1st of August, the first day of August, and I got my reports from my parental app on the Nintendo, you know, parental app on my iPhone. And I wanted to talk about the top three games that I played for the month and kind of go through them and just real quickly, briefly, just talk about them and why they're so much. So, 19 days this past month, I played Fortnite. That game has absolutely taken over my life. And essentially, for me, what I enjoy about it is the social aspect. I love hanging out with my friends and playing and doing battles and duos.
What up, Rado?
And just hanging out and doing stuff like that. Like, it's so much fun to get on with the voice chat and just hanging out and doing a good time. I the thing of it is for me anyway, the voice chat, since I've been going to built-in, isn't quite as good as the Discord voice chat. With Discord, I could actually talk to people and have a good time and not really, there was no breakup at all. It seems that when I play with my Sony Golds, when I'm in the air, there's a lot of breakup and disconnect. But the minute my character lands on the ground, there's no disconnect at all. And it's kind of strange that I can't figure it out. But that aside, here we go. Second is Octopath Traveler, which I had played for 3 days so far this month. And I gotta tell you, man, I love this game. I haven't really had a whole lot of time because essentially those 19 days I played Fortnite, the three that I played Octopath, was before I moved into the new place. And now I've kind of, like, because I'm into the unpacking and trying to do videos and all that, I really haven't had the time to spend. I'm off Saturday, all day Saturday. I'm gonna try to put in a lot of time in Octopath. And the last game that I've been playing for the past 2 days is Tanzia. And the reason why is because I'm going to do a review on this game. Got this game as a review code, and I appreciate that so much. So it's kind of cool, kind of fun, so let's move on. Here's something that a lot of people didn't see coming, and it's kind of, some people did, some people didn't. And that is, if you're playing games that are free to play, Nintendo Online, you do not need to have the paid service in order to still access online and play these games. This was a hot topic debate. A lot of people were asking these questions this week on the Red Shell radio show that I do with Patrick, Nintendo Talk. We basically got asked the question, you know, do we think that Nintendo is going to make people do this? Because Microsoft does, but Sony PlayStation doesn't. And it was kind of a questionable thing. And my feeling was at the time was, depends on whose servers these are on. If they're on Nintendo servers, I could totally see them charging for it. If it's on the game servers, like the studio servers, then how can they really charge for it anyway? But essentially, Nintendo's coming out and saying that, like, from the full launch of the Nintendo Switch Online membership service in 2018, online play requires a paid membership. The eShop listings for free-to-play do not include the same line anywhere in their info. And this is kind of interesting to see. I'm glad that Nintendo is kind of going this way and not going to charge people just to play online games that are free, essentially. You're going to pay for your Splatoon, you're going to pay for your Mario Kart and all that stuff, but this seems like this is a good move for Nintendo, and I'm happy to see them embracing this. It's more friendly customer service, in my opinion, that Nintendo's putting out this time around with the Switch, as opposed to in the past with, like, the Wii U and the Wii and all that. Seems like they kind of have their game together now, so that's good to see. Last story I have for the day, my friends over at Zoink Games. So when I went to E3 with Jules a couple months ago in June, I got the opportunity to meet Klaus, owner, CEO of Zoink Games. In that time, he actually broke out his Switch and handed it to me and said, "Here, man, you want to play Flippin' Death? You want to try it?" And so I got to play a little bit with it. I played one level, handed it back to him, said, "I don't want to play no more. I want to own this game. I want to play it, and I don't want to play it no more." So essentially, this game comes out August 7th. That's next week, man.
Insert the hype here!
I think a lot of people should be excited about this game. This game looks amazing. There's no doubt about that. The humor in it is awesome. It had me laughing all the time in the brief 10-15 minutes that I played this game. So good. It looks awesome. The music is home run. I'm not surprised at all. When Nintendo announced this last year during the first Nindies Direct or whatever, the Nindies Showcase, whatever it was, when Damon Baker came out and was like, "Hey, here's a bunch of indie games, and this is what we're doing, and this is where we're going, and this is how we're doing it." You know what I'm talking about. So for me, when I saw this, this was one of the standouts for me personally. I love Zombie Vikings. I love Stick It to the Man. So this, to me, is like more of that. Like, so much more of that. And I know that a lot of people got really hyped up for Feia, and that was where people were so excited with Zoink Games. But for me, it was always this game. Always this game that got me hyped up and so excited. I can't wait to own this game, to play this game, and get going. I will be doing a review on this game. I promise you that. Because this one, I love. I love Zoink Games. I love this game. Again, I played it for 10-15 minutes at E3. It was not on the demo floor. Thanks to Klaus, I was able to play it. Thank you so much for that, Klaus. But this is something that people really, really need to check out. This is something that you don't want to miss. You don't want to miss this game. Right now, mark your calendars, August 7th. Get in line. Get this game. Get ready for it. Let's go. So that is all. Thank you guys for watching today. I hope you enjoyed today's episode of Nintendo Guru Daily. You can follow me. Go, just head on over to NintendoGuru.com. You'll get all the deets, everything.
I'm sorry, I used that word. I apologize.
Everything that you need to know will be there. You can find the links to YouTube and all the podcasts we're doing and everything that's going on. That's where you want to go. I don't know. See you tomorrow. That is all. Peace out, Preston.